Today, we know that one in every 26 people develop epilepsy in their lifetime. The prevalence of this condition is one of many reasons doctors and researchers at the University of Iowa hospitals and clinics are committed to finding successful treatment options for their patients.
Epilepsy is the condition for the brain to produce seizures, independent of anything else that might be going on in the body, like a low blood sugar or a reaction to a medicine. But epilepsy is where the seizures come from, some dysfunction in the brain. And that dysfunction may be genetically based. And on the other hand, a number of cases of epilepsy are acquired.
We are the only level 4 epilepsy center in the state of Iowa. And that means that we offer services and treatments that are not available at other places in the state. As a result, there are some of the most difficult patients with epilepsy that are sent to us for evaluation. We're interested in understanding why epilepsy occurs and trying to understand the best ways to treat it. And this requires us to study patients in a monitoring unit where we measure brain waves and what they appear like when they have a seizure. And then that allows us to classify the seizures into different kinds. And each kind of seizure, each kind of epilepsy requires a different kind of treatment.
In addition to treating epilepsy patients from across the Midwest, the UI Epilepsy team is committed to aggressively seeking new ways to treat epilepsy, with the goal being to find a cure for this debilitating disease. Epilepsy can be a difficult disease to diagnose. It can manifest itself in different seizure types, and some seizures aren't epileptic. The more familiar a doctor is with epilepsy, the higher likelihood that the disease will be detected early.
We'll ask certain questions about why the seizures may have started, the risk factors that might be behind the epilepsy, including head injury, brain infections, family history. And that information then leads into tests where we take a picture of the brain with the MRI scan, or we look at the brain's electrical activity with the EEG test.
There are a range of treatment options for epilepsy. In some cases, anticonvulsive drugs can help relieve the seizures. If a patient doesn't respond to medication, surgery or electrical stimulation devices may be an option.
There's a high likelihood that if we can localize the seizures, and if they come from an area that can be safely resected by the neurosurgeon, we can produce a seizure-free outcome in that patient.
The reason that the patients are referred here to the University of Iowa is that it requires a special team and special facilities to do the types of evaluations that are needed to determine whether you're a good candidate for epilepsy surgery and also to perform the surgical procedures. And one of the specialized facilities that we have is the Epilepsy Monitoring Unit. And that unit is staffed with nurses who are highly trained in taking care of epilepsy patients. And also, there's special equipment and instrumentation that allows us to do the recordings that we need to carry out to find out where the seizure focus is.
Once the focus of the epilepsy is discovered, doctors can determine whether or not the patient is a candidate for surgery.
In a patient who's refractory, the odds, based on historic precedents of that patient becoming seizure-free with a new medication, are in the range of about 5%. On the other hand, if it's a temporal lobe focus and we do the resection surgery, the chance of being seizure-free is somewhere in the range of 70 to 80%. The efficacy difference, or how effective surgery is remarkable.
Some patients tell us that the seizures don't really bother them that much because they just become unconscious and are not aware that they're having a seizure, whereas their families are often bothered a lot more by it because when they have a seizure, it can look very scary. The patient's families then are often worried that they're going to hurt themselves. Also, there are many people who aren't aware that seizures can cause death in some cases. And so when families find that out, that often is something that bothers them, and they worry when a person has a seizure in their family that might be a fatal seizure.
The epilepsy team at the University of Iowa's Level 4 Epilepsy Center is committed to aggressively seeking new ways to treat epilepsy, with the goal being to find a cure for this debilitating disease.
We here at the University of Iowa are strongly committed to coming up with treatments for epilepsy and ultimately to cure epilepsy in the largest number of patients and to be able to allow patients with epilepsy to return to normal lives.
University of Iowa Healthcare. Changing medicine, changing lives.